Haven't had this good a time in ages.
That's true.
You know this one.
A little apple skipping down the path. Plow them all, along came a dwarf and kicked him in the arse. Plow them all, oh you arse back, dirty rotten scum. Plow them all,
the list is decommissioned.
Perfect. Let's go see Lurina.
Lurido's busy with that witch Sheila. Come back later.
Geralt, let's wait downstairs in the yard. Yes?
Do we wait until the Honorable Lady is done with the Venerable Hick?
Waste of time. Looks like a good number of Flotsam's town watchmen are here. We should look around. Did you see that arbalist behind the house? I'll get his attention. Give him something to think about. Why don't you find out what they're guarding so closely?
My apologies, gentlemen. I could not help overhearing your conversation.
What do you want?
In point of fact, it's a matter for the Witcher. I have an offer.
An offer? Interesting.
I suspect you did not come to Flotsam for pleasure alone.
You suspect right.
Do you know about the monster in the river?
What monster?
I expect someone will hire you to deal with it sooner or later. Thus, I presume that...
Stop presuming, expecting, and concluding. Just tell me what you want.
Our honored host is in possession of part of a trap, built especially for the beast in question.
Go on.
Around back, there's a storage area where Lurido keeps the treasures he confiscates from merchants and travelers. There are heaps of things out there.
Let me guess. You know exactly where I need to look.
Precisely. I saw Lurido's men carrying the contraption across the garden in a crate. They placed it on a platform by the wall, beyond which lies the craftsman's district.
Why are you telling me?
Why? We need to be rid of the beast as soon as possible. Good luck.
All right. I'll distract the guard. You sneak behind the house.
Brilliant as ever.
Plowing squirrels. I'd put him in their place.
You're all talk.
Soldier,
prove it.
Report to me
I
immediately.
I doubt anyone would stop you. We're too soft on them, that's the problem. Soldiers are bored. The garrison's thinning.
Now you're talking.
What do you want?
We don't need to
shut it, soldier.
Story,
have respect for your superiors or spend the rest of your life on the king's galley.
In Flotsam, we cut the hands off thieves.
I was looking for the privy.
You're lucky the commandant wants to see you. Come on!
Commandant, sir. We caught the witcher sneaking around the garden.
Bring him in and leave.
Yes, sir.
We were just discussing a certain matter. You here on business too?
The commandant wanted to see me.
In that case, I shall leave you to it.
Finally!
They didn't want to let me in while the sorceress was here.
Did you see her? Made up like a whore on parade day. They think they can do anything, those sorceresses. I heard what happened in Temeria. You know your name's on a warrant. It's unfortunate, though nothing that should impede our dealings. See, I'm the law round here, and the law needs to know what the legendary White Wolf's doing in this cesspit.
I'm looking for the man responsible for Foltest's death.
Here?
I know the Scoia'tael had a hand in it too. It's their trail I followed to Flotsam.
Lucky you found Bernard Lurido, then. If you're telling the truth, Yorveth's got raw blood on his hands. I can help you find him.
What about Vernon Roach? Why didn't you let him in?
Roach? Know the aura that surrounds him? Men like him act first and think later. And when they act, almost inevitably innocent blood flows. I trust you're on our side.
Whose side is that?
That of the people of Flotsam, of course. Terrorized by the elven bandits for years now.
My enemy's enemy is my friend. We barely escaped with our lives the last time we ran into Yorvith.
Damn squirrels draw ever nearer.
What about the elves and dwarves in the trading post? The smiths, peddlers, and hunters? They eat with you, sleep among you. Whose side are they on?
Hell if I know. That's my point, Witcher. When you fight for survival, you need to be sure who your friends are. The non-humans in Flotsam, sure, they eat, fuck, shit among us. But when Yorveth sounds the battle horns, who knows what they'll do?
I'm surprised they haven't turned on you already.
How so?
The town guards treat non-humans like shit. Frankly, I don't know what keeps them here.
I'll tell you what, Geralt. The hunger they'd face in the forest. But I grant you, those acts of, insubordination need to be stopped. Soldiers are simple men. When you see your mate die, a Scoia'tael arrow in his throat, it's hard to look favorably at the elf who sells your wife colored kerchiefs. You're a witcher. Your job is to protect the simpletons from monsters. I protect them from the danger that lurks amongst the trees.
I see where this is going.
Yorvith's no better than a monster that attacks those who go out to gather kindling. Matter of fact, he's worse. He's smarter and crueler.
How do we get him?
I don't want you to kill him. Even you don't have a hope against his entire force. I've an idea, but I'd rather not go into it now. The squirrels are up to something. Every night their scouts come closer. I suspect they plan to attack the barge moored in the port.
What's on the barge?
You mean who? Bandits, murderers, rapists. On their way to the dungeons at Drakenborg. As soon as...
their infamous leader joins them. The cherry on the cake and Bernard Lorido's crown trophy.
Couldn't have put it better myself. As long as Yorveth remains free, humans, elves, and dwarves will live alongside each other in deep distrust. I've got to learn what the pointy-eared rat is planning.
How am I supposed to get that information?
You underestimate me, Witcher. True, I have my prejudices, but I'm not blinded by them. Take your friend Zoltan, for instance. He contacted Yorveth.
How can Zoltan help if he can't go outside the walls?
Step by step, Geralt. That's how you build trust.
You could start by tending to a problem we have. A beast. The Cairn has blocked all boat traffic. I'm losing tolls, but that is, the trading post is losing revenue. Kill the Cairn and I'll declare your friends acquitted of their crimes.
Then Zoltan can take you to see Yorveth.
I'm a witcher. I don't work for free.
Of course you don't. Help us capture the Scoia'tael commander, and you'll be rewarded generously, straight from the trading post's treasury.
I'll see what I can find out.
Now you stir up storms wherever you go. I actually believe you'll bring peace to Flotsam. Don't disappoint this town, Geralt. Farewell.
Entry only on the Commandant's express orders. Off you go. No passage.
Haven't had this good a time in ages.
You know this one.
A little elf was skipping down the path. Pramble, pramble. Along came a dwarf and kicked him in the arse. Plowmore, plowmore.
Sniffing around
oh,
like dogs in a
dirt,
rubbish dump.
Plowmore, plowmore.
Turned me away at the door, again. The bastard.
Oh, fuck you, ma'am. Plow
there. We'll meet later. Don't forget your weapons on the way out.
Thank you.
I tell him, I'm taking your pouch. Or your pouch and your life.
What do you want to prove with those...
Good day.
That prick Lorino turned his nose up, eh?
Bah!
Glad we made the deal.
True enough. Sometimes you just... We know.
We should commandeer a barge and sail to Mizima.
Nothing left for us here. There, we'll have a new...
It's not that simple.
I'd miss the old turf.
How many more can there be?
Damn, you're ugly.
Winter's Nest. Damn it. Nest.
at yourself. Hey, boss, look who's graced our smithy. That titan of the art of smithing can't hear us. Busy, work's a blur in his hands. And how are you, Witcher? Things working out for you?
Nice workshop.
Bah, it's no workshop, just a simple forge. But thanks for the compliment, both in my name and the master's. So how can we help you, eh?
Greetings. Mind if I take a look at what you have in stock?
Certainly. You're welcome to. I'm Fioravanti, a merchant. Not to be nosy, but weren't you hired to kill the Cairn? I've had my fill of this place, and I'll be glad when the blockade is finally lifted.
Lerida won't let you traitors out until it suits him. Seems he needs you here for some reason.
What's that supposed to mean, dammit? Is he organizing some international trade fair? I'm a subject of King Demavend. And I tell you...
Demavend's dead. Now, if you don't mind, can we get down to business?
Careful with those.
Thank you.
many more can there be?
Thank you, Master. Drives me mad. This cursed wood is full of scum, and that horseman has lost his mind.
Who might that be?
The troll! For years he's been collecting tolls at the bridge, from which he's to keep the bridge tidy and drive away the scum.
What's the problem, then?
Merchants from the port sent me to find out the what and why, seeing as this is the only path out to the port inland. But I found the bridge in ruins, and that cheeky cocksucker asked for liquor to let me pass! Across that pile of rubble, I says, and he smacks me so hard I see stars.
Florido's put a price on his head.
If Florido had his way, he'd cut us off from the world, that son of a bitch. We need a bridge, but a working one. And we need a troll, but a sober one. If you're looking to make some coin, hold off on killing the troll and see the village chief instead. He'll tell you all you need to know.
Damn Europe.
That's the spirit.
Ah! name's the Witcher. Think he'll agree?
No.
So how's it going, dear? Everything all right at the household?
Youngster.
I've brought some Necker remains as proof of...
I know what they prove, Witcher. The reward is yours.
Any idea why Lurido put a price on the troll's head?
Commandant Lurido has Flotsam's welfare in mind.
Mm-hmm. But the troll tends to the bridge, keeps it in repair.
Not likely. To start with, that's a dangerous beast. In addition, he pays no taxes on the tolls he collects.
How's it going, dear? Everything all right at the household? And how do you find country?
Something's troubling. That's all. What's a bloody witcher?
Welcome to my modest shop.
What do you deal in?
All kinds of incense, mainly. For meditation, rejuvenation, cooking, making medicine, rituals, whatever you require.
Everything in order?
Oh,
Any work for a witcher?
Enough work for three, but what of it? We're poor folk.
I'm sure we can work something out.
Ye best go to Flotsam Town Square near the inn. There are notices on the board there. Just leave the trawl be, please, no matter what the townsfolk say.
I heard you don't want to get rid of the troll.
Who'll maintain the bridge when he's gone?
Hire some people.
Know the cost of a craftsman these days? That idiot troll looks after the bridge for petty tolls, more or less.
The bridge is in ruins and the troll's robbing people.
Aye, it's because he's hit the bottle. If you could help him stop boozing.
I'm a witcher, not a nanny.
I'll pay you well.
How much?
100 orens.
200.
You're costly, but what the hell? Let them see I place the village's welfare above all else.
No.
No what?
No passage. Give Volker you passage.
Do I look like an innkeeper to you?
No, Volker. No passage.
How many more can there be?
No.
No what?
No passage. Give Volker you passage.
Why should I pay you?
My bridge?
This is a pile of rubble, not a bridge. You're getting nothing from me.
Ah, from me? You get in mug.
betray no one else, Sylvie, bitch.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What's going on here?
This whore's a Scoia'tael spy.
Any evidence?
What's it to you?
Easy. She loiters around the garrison, kicketting us. Roderick says he boned her, but I don't believe that.
I did!
That's your evidence?
Two of our lads are missing. Last seen with her.
I only spoke to them. Then they went off towards the caves. That's all I know.
The bitch is lying. She led them into an ambush.
This ought to be easy enough to resolve. Look inside the caves.
But they're crawling with all sorts of filth.
I'll do it, but you'll pay me. Wait for me at the harbor.
What was that?
My medallion vibrates when you're nearby, and it only vibrates near magic or danger.
Maybe it's warning you not to make a pass at me, lest I slap you.
You're right. I should watch what I do.
Listen carefully. People may say I'm a witch, but I don't deal in spells. You don't look like someone who'd come for a charm or a curse. So you either seek out sensations or hunt witches. Whichever the case.
I'm not about to denounce you, nor do I want to see you dancing naked in the moonlight before Veopatis' shrine.
How dare you?
I want to buy some herbs.
Herbs?
For personal use.
Something's troubling me. I don't want...
Ah!
Just don't start any brawls. Peace and quiet. Get it?
Of course.
I've got my eye on you.
So how's it going, Dick? And how do you find it, Katrina? Was it worth it? Marrying in a dome?
Love is where you find it.
Your gallery.
Here comes the Witcher.
I'm in fear, not in fear from now.
Careful.
Never.
No.
No what?
No passage. Give Volker you passage.
Do I look like an in...
No, Volker. No passage. Enough! Don't hit! I'd be good!
You're drunk.
Vodka good? Head hurt, aye. But no pain in brain.
Brain pain always comes with a reason.
They kill my woman. She good. She cooked meat.
Who killed her?
Don't know. Me sit on bridge. Go home. No meat smell. Woman dead. Had no head. Guts to drink. In can't go. People would kill. But guts to drink.
If I find your woman's murderers, will you put aside the booze?
You no find none.
You'll see. I've got friends here. I'll talk to them.
Oh, it's just the Witcher.
Something's troubling me.
It's a dog's life, Geralt, I'll tell you that much.
Damn, that was close. Innkeep! Vodka!
Triss Merigold! Lice eat me, but you are a treat to behold. Just a little pale.
Magic takes its toll, but I'll be all right. Good to see you in your beard again.
Can somebody tell me what happened? You set off a month ago for Zoltan's wedding.
That got fucked. There will be no wedding.
Did you hear about Foltest?
Rumors travel faster than the wind.
Winds and rumors. I want to know the truth.
I want to know how Foltest died. And the dragon, was there really one there? And who rules Temeria now?
Dandelion, calm down. You'll choke on your liquor. The dragon, well, the dragon appeared and that's all I know.
But where did the Lavalettes get a dragon? We heard it fought on their side, huge as a barn, they say.
Dragons don't usually take sides. Maybe its lair was nearby and it just felt threatened.
If you hadn't driven it off, Foltest might not have taken the castle.
Maybe. We'll never know for sure. No wedding, Zoltan.
Ha! The Breckenrigs broke off the engagement because some limp prick put it about that I joined the uprising in Vizima. My would-be pop-in-law refused to let a rebel firebrand join the family. Innkeep, where's our drink?
It was like this. We got to Mahakam a week after the Grand Master died. Bought Zoltan an absolutely grand doublet, a pair of Garibaldi Krakows, and as a gift for Eudora, a jade stone as big as my fist.
You were broke as a joke by the time Dandelion threw me a bachelor party at an establishment called the Tight Lane.
Next day, we went over to the Breckenrigs. They welcomed us in, sat us down, and proceeded to discuss the superiority of Mahakaman mining know-how over any other. And that went on until dinner. Just when I thought I'd learned more than I ever wanted to know about mining, they served the soup.
You could have held
Old Breckenrigg rose and he says, "A real dwarf works a mine, not chases fame on the battlefield."
You'll never believe this, Geralt, but they served duck blood soup. It was as black as tar. They must have dropped lumps of coal into the pot.
"Eat," Breckenrigg says, then proceeded to slop two full bowls of the shite. Old goat, hope his mind caves in on his head.
"Since when have you worked for Roach?"
"Hey, nobody said a word when you went out to save Temeria from the Grand Master and his mutants."
"Relax, Dandelion. I was just asking. Do what you want. You're an adult, kind of."
That wasn't very supportive.
Laugh away. At least I decided to do something constructive.
"You used to spy for Redania. Now you're spying for Temeria. Some might call you a traitor."
"Ever tried to live off of poetry alone? The truth is, I'm a citizen of the world. As long as I don't serve Emperor Emir, I'm not doing any harm."
"Even me, Geralt. You play the spy a bit, get bored, and drop it. You know how he is."
"Lerido said you're working with the Scoia'tael, Zoltan."
"I have done many things in my life, Geralt, but I have never stooped to banditry."
"The Scoia'tael don't consider themselves bandits."
"But I am no Scoia'tael."
"Triss, you're the expert on Temeria. Tell us who's in charge now."
"It's chaotic and getting worse. The old families are fighting for supremacy, no holds barred."
"Baron Kimbleton, Count Merivale, I bet."
"Among others. After the assassination, while Geralt was in the dungeon, the lords convened in a field near Lavalette Castle to choose a new ruler. 3 days they debated, and it looked more like a bazaar than a meeting of nobles. Except the trade was in court and ministry positions, spheres of influence, royal privileges."
"Ha! Humans!"
"In spite of several duels and 2 poisonings, no king was chosen. Civil war was in the air."
"Where were the mages?"
"Aye, where were the grey eminences of this world when they were truly needed?"
"They weren't invited. Neither was I. But if not for their intervention, or rather that of a few influential sorceresses, Baron Kimbolt would have taken the throne."
"I was invited to sing at his court once. Afterwards, he refused to pay me, and the food was awful. No way I'll stay in Temeria if he's crowned."
"Did they ultimately resolve anything?"
"No. It ended as usual. Sadly, John of Talus remains our only hope."
"Ah, the victor at Brenna, and Foltest's most tried and true field commander."
"Hmm. During the deliberations, he was several days' march from Lavalette Labs, with an additional 2,000 armed men in tow. He's to keep the peace until a rightful monarch is chosen."
"He could find that ruling is to his liking."
"Natalis is a soldier at heart. He's not suited to rule, and I don't believe he even wants to."
"He's got the army behind him."
"Which is why he can guarantee peace. Why, a tenuous one, sure, but that's always better than civil war. Besides which, he's deeply in debt to a dwarven bank in which Philippa Eilhart, as sorceress, holds significant stake."
"I think I've heard enough about politics." "Foltest Killer lay in wait in the tower where the Lavalettes had hidden the royal bastards. He was well informed."
"Wait a minute. What were you doing there?"
"I was protecting the king. After the first attempt, Foltest began treating me as his lucky charm. He ordered me to be at his side during the battle. The dragon separated us from the rest of the army. The killer disguised himself as a monk, a blind one at that. He let Foltest greet his children, waited until I had walked off, and cut the king's throat from ear to ear."
"How did he flee?"
"Jumped out a window into the river below. Yorv with Scoia'tael were waiting in a boat. It was planned."
"And you're chasing him because he murdered the king?"
"I was accused of the murder. I need to clear my name. Besides, I looked him in the eye before he escaped. He's a witcher. Then some brave Temerian soldiers showed up, piled on me, and knocked me out."
"Save yourselves, good folk! The beast attacks!"
"We better get out there. Someone's casting spells."
What sort of sorceress are you? A lot of good you did. Can't you hear me? Why didn't you help him?
He's alive, isn't he?
The beast nearly pulled him in the water while you stood staring like a calf at a shit-covered clover.
Watch your words.
Where's this beast?
Ask her.
Geralt.
Ah, I guess we knew each other.
Oh, look here. Birds of a feather.
Let's say, I've heard of you.
Master Witcher, this is foolish. The beast near pulled Sozek into the depths, and you're simply chatting with this damsel.
All right. What happened?
I came to Flotsam to kill the Cairn.
Cairn?
The monster that has effectively blocked the port. A moment ago, I had the good fortune to see it in all its splendor, but the local folk scared it away.
Good fortune? You hear that, Sozek? That was some good fortune for you.
Why's the beast in the port all of a sudden, eh? Summoned by the witch, perchance?
To see it in all its splendor.
Sozek doesn't look too good. Lay him inside somewhere.
Right, we've dawdled enough already. Come on, lads, let's go.
What's this? I was ready for a rumble there.
Shut it, and come on.
I apologize for interrupting, but I am Louis Merce, and I am chief person in charge of all matters related to monster hunting in Flotsam. It is in this capacity that I must inquire if you're willing to attempt to resolve the problem of our so-called Cairn, the beast that now blocks all trade traffic on the river.
So, Witcher, are we willing?
I usually work alone.
I was here first, and I'll not relinquish this contract. My way or the highway, as the locals put it.
Fine. Your way it is.
You must contact the merchants on the waterfront as regards any rewards. Madame de Tansaville has, I believe, already conducted some preliminary negotiations.
That I have.
In that case, don't let me keep you.
Triss, how long must I wait for you to introduce us?
Sheila de Tansaville, advisor to Queen Zulika of Kovir.
Kovir is a long way north.
True. I had my doubts if the Cairn was worth the journey, but those were dispelled with what it showed today.
Here to hunt down some ingredients?
Triss Merigold. Sharp as ever.
You're thinking that...
Troll eyes, ghoul venom, virgin's blood, all those disgusting marvels we take from dying species. To throw into the cauldron at Sabbaths. Right, Triss?
Absolutely. Virgins are a dying breed.
Oh my. Your sense of humor seems to be intact, too. But enough of these pleasantries. Tell me, Geralt. You saw the tentacle. What do you make of it all?
The beast must be huge. Maybe inhabited one of the Pontar's tributaries before, hunting animals. Then it grew for some reason, and hunger drove it to seek fresh pastures.
And on the Pontar it found trade barges burgeoning with obese, slow-moving merchants. But hardly Geralt. Cedric claims the Cairn emerged from the northern swamps approximately 1 month past.
Cedric?
An elf. Formerly a Scoia'tael. Strange bird. But he knows quite a bit about the area and its living wonders.
I need to look around, find out a few things.
An investigation. Witches' rituals, extracting secrets and such.
More or less. I'll talk to the merchants about the reward. Pay Cedric a visit and we'll get back to you.
You'll find me at the inn. I've rented lodgings there, on the upper floor.
You know the inn's also a whore house.
Thanks for the warning.
Go on, a wee bit more. Change your grip.
Humans know as much about arm wrestling as I know about screwing trolls.